Assalamu alaikum and good morning to all dear students of class 8 girls. I am your physics teacher and today we are going to discuss the fourth lecture of our subject physics. Okay girls, today I am going to discuss about the branches of physics. Okay, and girl, this book topic is given in your book on page number 6. Okay. Well, there are different branches of physics, but only few of them are given in your book. So we are going to discuss only those branches of physics which is already given in your book. Okay girls, the first one branch of physics which is given in your book on page number 6, girls, table number 1.1. okay, the first one branch is, girls, mechanics. Okay, what is mechanics, girls? Mechanics, it is the branch of physics which deals with the motion of object and how it relates to the forces. Okay, so in this branch of physics we will discuss about the motion of object. Okay, motion of material object under the action of force. Okay, any type of object which is in state of motion. Okay, suppose if we take an example of motion of human body, motion of vehicles, motion of birds, motion of animals, any type of object which is in state of motion, and the motion of object under the action of force. Okay, that how force acts on a body and that how force can produce motion in a body. Okay, now this is the definition of physics, or this is the definition of mechanics. So first I will tell you about the motion. Okay, that what is motion, or how we can define the term motion. Okay girls, there are two possibilities. The object may be at rest condition, or the object may be in state of motion. Okay, so the term motion or word motion can be defined as, if a body change its position with respect to some observer, okay, with the passage of time, so this state is known as, or the body is said to be in state of motion. Okay, so the body is said to be in state of motion. Okay, if a body does if a body change its position with the passage of time with respect to some observer, so we can say the body is in state of motion. Okay, and rest mean rest position is also known as static position. Okay, so at rest condition can be defined as, if a body does not change. Okay, if a body does not change its state of if a body does not change its position with respect to some observer with the passage of time, so this body is said to be at rest condition. Okay, now girls, observer girls, all types of human beings are observer. Okay, you are observer, I'm observer, all human beings are observer. Okay, suppose if we take an example of a classroom. Okay, number of students are sitting in a classroom, and suppose teacher is in state of motion, so all students are observer, and because teacher is changing its position with the passage of time, so it's mean the teacher is in state of motion. Okay, the body of teacher is in state of motion, but all students are considered at are said to be observer. They are considered as observer. Okay, and teacher is also an observer. Okay, so any person who observes the motion of object, or who observes the position of another object, so that person is simply known as observer. Okay girls, a simple example is this, that suppose a person is standing at a bus stop. Okay, this is, suppose this is observer or a person. Okay, and this is the bus stop. Okay, and a car is also parked near the bus stop. Okay, now suppose this car is at rest condition, suppose. Okay, and this person is observing the car. Okay, so it's mean this person is observer. Okay, and if suppose number of cars are passing over, okay, and this person is still observing the position, the motion of object, the motion of persons, the motion of vehicles. So it means this person is known as observer. So any person, anybody who observes the position of another object, so that is known as word, that is known as observer. Okay, so I think you you know it very well that what is motion. Okay, girls, actually there are three types of motion. Okay, one is known as translatory motion. Okay, second one is known as rotatory motion, and the third one is known as vibratory motion, which we will discuss in chapter number 2, kinematics. Okay, now as I told you that mechanics is a branch of physics which deals with the motion of material object under the action of force. Now the second one term is force. Okay, how we can define the word force, or what is force? Girls, force can be defined as the applied push or pull is known as word, that is known as force. Applied push or pull, okay, that is known as force. Or it can be defined as it is a physical quantity which moves, okay, or tend to move. Tends to move mean try to move, okay, which try to move a static body. As I told you, the word static mean at rest condition, okay, or which stop or tend to stop a moving body. So this is known as force. Physical quantity mean which can be observed, any type of quantity which can be observed, which can be measured, so that is known as physical quantity. Okay, any type of quantity which can be observed, which can be felt, which can be measured, which can be observed, so that is known as the physical quantity. Okay, so force is a type of physical quantity, okay, which can move a static body, okay, and which can stop a moving body, or which try to move a static body, or which try to move stop a moving body. So this is known as word, this is known as force. Okay, there are different types of forces, such as gravitational force, force of gravity, nuclear forces, magnetic forces. Okay, these are the different types of forces. Okay, now examples are girls, falling object. Okay, falling object means, suppose if we take an example of a ball, okay, which is thrown vertically upward or vertically downward, so mean ball is a falling object. Okay, so when we discuss the motion of this falling object, this ball, under the action of force, so this phenomena is known as word, this phenomena is known as mechanics. Okay, second one example is friction. Okay, friction, what is friction? Girls, friction is also known as frictional force. Okay, friction is also known as frictional force. Okay, and how we can define the word frictional force? Frictional force can be defined as the force which opposes the motion of one body over the surface of another body. So this is known as the frictional force. Okay, suppose if we take an example of two objects which are in contact, okay, suppose sole of the shoe and the ground. Okay, now sole of the shoe and the ground are in contact. Okay, so there is a type of force present between the sole of the shoe and the ground which opposes the motion of one body over another body. Okay, you know it very well, girls, that a small lines are given on the sole of the shoe. What is the purpose of that lines? That this small lines produces force of friction between the sole of the shoe and the ground. Okay, so there is a type of force present between the sole of the shoe and the ground which opposes the motion of one body over the surface of another body. So this is known as the frictional force. Suppose if we take an example of wheel of a car and the ground, so there is a frictional force present between the tire of a car and the ground. okay. So when we discuss the motion of a material or motion of any object under the action of force, so this phenomena is known as what? This is known as mechanics. Okay.